The latest shipment of replacement soldiers had just arrived on Vraks. The men formed up and marched along to their assigned rally point. As they went, they approached the officers' club, where a lone Krieg soldier stood guard at the door. Omega 773. The sergeant ordered the formation to a halt as he went to the HQ next door to get his paperwork in order. As the green recruits stood there, they started talking amongst themselves. Some of them were talking about how much they liked their new equipment, especially the STC bayonets. Omega 773, overhearing this, started to talk to them in a voice that sounded like every morning. Instead of brushing his teeth, he gargled gravel.
"Your new bayonet. Your new bayonet. New. Why, back in my day, we were given rusty radioactive bayonets that still had chunks of Nurgle custis on them. And we were thankful, even if cleaning the blade gave you soul rot and caused your flesh to slough from your bones. We didn't mind, because the extra radioactivity gave the bayonet a little more kick when you slid it in between some traitor's ribs. And have a blade made out of metal? Sheer luxury. But sure, you want to affix your new bayonet? You go right ahead. You want some tea and biscuits with that? A foot massage? You know what? We're going to have a mass charge done. But heck, why don't you go back to the barracks and sleep in? We'll call you on by the, fourth wave or so. We wouldn't want to deprive you of your beauty sleep now, would we? Oh, by the way, here's a comb so you can brush your hair and admire yourself in the reflection of your new, shiny bayonet."
Before anyone could respond, the sergeant returned and ordered them to form up and follow him. As they marched away, Omega 773 muttered to himself,
"Bah, recruits today spoiled the lot of them."
The new recruits talked among themselves. Some muttered that he was just an Omega. Clearly, he shouldn't be telling anyone how to sacrifice. One guardsman in particular seemed quite thoughtful, obviously thinking deeply about the Omega's words. The soldier next to him tapped him on the shoulder. "Hey, 228, you're quiet." Epsilon 228 seemed to come back from wherever his thoughts had taken him.
"What? Oh, yeah, just thinking."
"Like you, be strong to hold the powers of the sun. To dream, believe in strength. Now I'm the only one. Only one."
Can I be your superhero?